Yep, I'm gonna.
Oh, because
you said
in
it's
there?
A 2 year old.
So go ahead and smoke.
The bottom.
Oh. Smoke the bottom entrance.
I'm assuming there's four. And I'm assuming that's the one that's in the Hollywood right now.
Yeah.
Oh, it's all on the bottom?
Yeah, David.
Yes.
That's me too.
Wait until we have to feed all those.
I'll call him David. David, all right?
That's the problem. I'm exploding.
So go ahead and put some smoke in there. Front entrance. When you smoke it, so first off, let me see the smoker for a sec. Smoke in the hive, make sure you're not putting hot smoke and brands out, okay? Put the smoke air entrance right at the hole and put it in. So you're smoking the hive. You don't need to gas them. You're listening for the buzz. But if you on a day like today where there's a bit of a breeze and you're out away, you're not getting smoke in the hive.
Okay, they're so buzzing now.
You got a little smoke there. You're gonna go in the top, grab the hive tool. You're gonna take this off.
Think that one is busting with bees or what?
I'd say it's busting. So go ahead and smoke down into the cover.
Looks like it would be a good candidate.
And let's just cover it up. So what's gonna happen here? You're masking the pheromone of any of the guards. Anybody that thinks the hive is on fire and is gonna do whatever is gonna go head into the honey and fill themselves up. As they fill themselves up, you're standing in front of my camera, by the way. As they fill themselves up, they're going to engorge, and they probably can't sting you, right? If they really do fill themselves up, and they become a little more docile. So, but come back, come on back, right there for me. All right, so we've had a little time. They've been smoked. Let's go get them. So we're going to set this back here. Oh, there's your foam on that.
This one in the front.
You put it over to the far side of you, over on there. Okay. A little bit of smoke on the top. You're looking at the bees. Are they looking at you? Do you see eyes?
No, not really.
A couple here and there are looking. Just a little smoke on. You can go through. So again, you got a 10 frame box here. These things are packed all the way through, and the bees are all the way down. Yep,
okay.
Big eyes, stout body, drone.
So I want to put on the hanger?
You want to take one frame out first before you do it. So there's two schools of thought here. You can go after the first frame or the second frame.
I'm going to work from this side. Is
okay,
that right?
That's good, because that's what I prefer. So let's not put this on yet, because if you pull that first one out, you're going to roll them across.
Normally what you want to do is be working from behind the hive. You really don't want to be working from in front, but we have so many people crowded around, we're going to have somebody in the front, but it's really not the best place to be.
Okay.
No fast movements, by the way.
It is.
You're going to put foundation on?
Nice and slow. Put it over the hive. First thing you do, always look under frame, make sure the queen's not there before you take it out. In fact, we could look on an upper cover, but this box, you couldn't find another bee. It's supposed to be marked.
So what are we looking at?
I did
here?
I
this
made
is pretty much capped.
I think 10
this is all capped, this is all capped honey Bob. That you got here.
Hey, Bob.
So when we see pollen, I would like you to point that out. Yeah.
Yes, they are.
Bob.
Yes.
Did you say this is a marked queen in this
yes,
middle?
Yes, she should be marked with a white dot from last
okay,
year.
So we're going to
sure.
pull apart a couple and hang them and then pull?
That's what this guy had. I had six of them. So anyway, what I did is foundation.
One thing you do with the tool when you do that is just turn it this way.
Okay.
And that helps you spread it out. Okay, check and see if you got a queen on here. So you're starting to see some brood. When you see some brood, there's a possibility that she's on there. Let me help you with the frame for a second here. So you're looking at the frame. I'm looking at it. I want to stand with the sun to my back so I can see what's going on. So you got larvae in there.
Let me make sure the queen's larvae.
The larvae are the bigger ones down here, the big white ones.
Right, right? So you're holding the frame and you want to look at the other side. Just grab the ears and flip it over.
Kevin, okay. How do the brood, how does the laying frequency look? Nice and solid?
It's a solid tight pattern all the way through.
Check out the emergency cell on the bottom of that frame. Show them the emergency cell there.
Yeah, so when you look, you see these frames that are facing down.
I mean,
these are possible queen cells. And what you want to do with these is you want to get them to the sun, to your back, and you want to look down inside that hole and see if there's any queens in there. If there's any liquid, and there isn't. And so you'll have to trust me or you're going to have to hold on to it. But so here's what's going on. You got comb on the bottom. These are drone down here, and they were connected to the frame down below. So when we pulled them off, we broke the frame open. We broke it open. That's what you're seeing, why you're seeing white larvae.
So the big white ones are the drones.
So if you look at this, they've got them all covered, but if you look here, typical frame, right? You're going to see the larvae on the bottom. You usually see a pollen ring around the top.
Just the pollen.
Here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to walk over there and I'm going to have you look over my shoulder so you see the sun. Now look inside the cells. See what you see. See the eggs?
Yep.
See the larvae?
Keep them smoked.
Yeah.
Not too close, you don't want to burn them.
And they always put honey in the corner. So there's a biology of how they actually fill the frame out and why the honey gets in the corner.
See them bringing it in?
Yeah, they look like they've got
orange and yellow.
Yeah, yellow.
Now. Yay, baby, there's eggs up there. So we want to keep this one because we want to use this one of the new hives. That's what we're doing, right? Maybe we want to put it in.
Yep. This one, I don't see any pollen in here. It's completely loaded into it's the third frame. Yeah. You can see what's going on. All right, so why are these bees up in the top head in? See them on the top? Why is that one head in? Because we smoked them, they're taking the honey, right? So this is a good one right here. So Bob, you want to take the bees and all, right?
Yeah, well, yeah, because we, you want to do the thing with the queen excluder?
We could do that with this one.
Yeah, let's.
All right, so listen, brood, nurse bees, this is what we want. If we put them in that box, they're not going to fly away. They're going to stay in here. They're not loyal to the queen. They're loyal to the brood. So our first box for our nuke or our new hive is this one.
If we have enough to make a 10 frame, don't you? So the other thing is we want to keep them covered just so they don't dry.
Go
so
for the next frame.
Dry out or get too,
let's give a little smoke there.
Get
just down off the top.
Take the string part and push it down in between.
Yeah.
From the top.
From the top so you don't hit the.
And then you use the bent side to pry them apart.
The twigs.
Yeah. And look at that.
So you can cover off the bees. They don't want to see the light.
This is really cat.
Flip it this way, Dave.
Right. Never upside down, though.
There you go.
No.
You could look in.
Don't go all the way up, though.
Well, the other way you could do it is you take the frame and you turn it this way and you twirl it in your fingers.
So this is all right, like this?
Yeah, that's as far as you want to go.
Turn it upside down, and there's nectar in it, it'll pour all over you.
Yeah.
So this is pretty much all capped.
That's all capped.
Is this all capped brood, or is this
capped brood right here, see it?
No, and this is larvae,
I'm assuming.
On the edge.
And there's honey in the corners.
So
you got down here.
The brood is because it's
what are these right here,
yellow.
David? What are these?
Those are drones.
The drones, right? The bullet-shaped ones are drones.
Okay.
And I don't see any queen cells on the bottom here.
So this one being filled with brood, we want to put it over there.
We're going to put it over there. Let's take a look on the other side. What do you got?
We've got some drone.
Yeah.
And we've got a lot of brood.
Okay. We haven't found the queen, right?
No.
Yeah.
Nope. So you could take that one and put it in. I'll open it.
Bob, do you have any entrance reducers?
I don't.
Next one?
But I'll show you what a trick that I do.
I have one in my truck.
I use painter's tape. That's what I did in the hell all winter, believe it or not. I just keep tape up, except for that much, right over the mountain.
So when you reach it in, just make sure you're not pinching.
Okay, now this one is a lot of open nectar, right?
Well, no, you've got looks like some pollen in there. You've got all kinds of stuff.
Okay, the pollen is that colorful stuff that's only halfway out.
That's right.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, does that usually come all the way out, or is that concave like that?
Usually, you don't fill it to the top unless they're absolutely packing it in.
Okay, so this is one we want to put over there.
So let's take a look.
The stuff on the right.
Yeah, there's one with a lot of pollen on it right there.
Yeah. It looks like it got at least one or two emergency cells on the bottom of that.
If they need it,
look in those.
There's one.
You know, when you're transferring like this, you do want to have some open comb.
Yep.
You know?
Okay.
Yeah.
So, because this has all open nectar and pollen.
And it also has capped brood, right?
And some capped brood, right?
Is it worker or is it drone?
It's drone. Okay. I see a lot of drone on here.
Okay.
I forget we have some empty comb in here. If we want some empty comb to make these up, we'll take it out of this bottom box.
So is this a saver or a transfer?
We'll figure that out in a bit. Let's see. Everybody see the pollen in there? We've got plenty of pollen.
Oh wow.
Right.
I am.
So in your nuke that you want to build or in your split, you do want to have a fine mix of pollen and nectar. So this one really wouldn't be a bad one to put in. In fact, why not?
This is the one without the excluder.
Yeah.
It's hot. Did we go in the tops and the bottom?
We went in here. There's hot honey here. These are almost all empty comb. These are honey down here.
Actually,
this is
going
clean it up.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
What are these?
What do you got
different
there?
Shapes.
What do they look like?
They look like super cells. Or a lot of drone cells.
A lot of drone.
Okay.
What does a lot of drone tell you?
You guys want to come in?
A lot of drone says that it's time for mating for the queens.
Right.
That one's got pollen on it too, right?
Why is that frame funky?
Yeah.
Why is that a funky frame?
Oh God, look at it.
So it doesn't look like they like the surface of it, right?
Yeah,
this is one of those plastic ones, and typically what happens over time, when they come new, they come with like a wax coating on it. But sometimes with plastic frames and not wax foundation, And this is an old school plastic frame. They wouldn't build it out. It's kind of an ugly comb.
That's clear.
I have some of those. They're from the late 90s.
What does that look like? What do you see here? What's this?
Yeah.
What's that?
Yeah.
And what's that?
There's two on the bottom too.
Look at that. Those
emergency cells?
Those are called emergency cells. Which means what? That's what they use if they gotta use it real fast. They have something started.
So they've always got a backhoe.
Yeah, I've read that they call them bell cells. I've heard all kinds of little names for them.
They won't have an egg in
it, right? Have a little shoot.
So what's interesting, look, if you look through this, you can see the pollen from the other side. See all the pollen that's on the screen? Look at the other side. It's loaded with pollen. I don't think they sell it. I happen to have a whole bunch over here. So I don't think we want to do anything with that. Let's go take a look. So Bob, what else do you want?
What do we have in here so far?
Two frames of brood and a frame full of pollen honey bags.
Okay, so we're going to take some of the cool honey frames from that last hive. So we'll put at least two of those in,
yeah.
Right?
What else do you want?
Cap brood would be best, actually.
There you go. You got it.
All right. Somebody want to pick out a couple of nice frames of honey over here?
Well, these two are stuck.
So we want to give them
that one.
So before you pull them apart, yeah, go through and break. So wait, take a peek in there. You're going to see, and don't lean over, but look. If you lean over, you tend to alarm them. See how the combs are bridged together. If you continue to pull that over, you're going to completely split that foundation. So what you want to do is you want to get it apart and then gently take your hive tool and just separate them. So that's why there was a hole in that one that we saw before.
So I want to put it back a little bit?
Whatever it takes, go ahead and get them cut apart, hopefully in the middle.
Seeing some drone cells. I'm not really seeing any brood in this one, except for those drone cells.
Okay, and that's really an ugly frame, so I don't know if we're gonna. So lay that on the cover, lay it flat.
Every once in a while, I get a stubborn.
Nice and slow. And we'll just kind of put it back in shape if we can. See if we can embed that wire, just kind of push it in with the hive tool. Just kind of nick it in there. You can, yep.
Got a bunch in my house.
Got honey on my fingers now.
Who's got the smoker?
I'd hang this one.
It's over here, buddy. Over here.
Yeah, they're getting a little aggressive out here, so you might want to
have a smoker smoke in the entrance.
Somebody smoke them.
And the smoker is where?
Right here.
Do I want to smoke this other hive at all?
Smoke them all.
Oh.
Smoke them all.
Bad things happen here, I can tell you.
As long as that wasn't
frame. It wasn't me, Ed. Dave, wasn't me.
I was watching them.
as long as it's not a frame, we're in business.
All right, look, I don't know that we want anything else out of this top box. Let's
is the queen definitely down below? Or
have to believe
check
at this
here?
Point she's below. Just slide it over. What do we see?
Laura?
Yeah.
Get one of those frames open? Of drawn cones.
Here, right there. Oh, this one right here. Okay. No, that one there.
Lots of drones.
Actually, get two of them, please.
All right.
There you go.
Got it.
So there's no brood here, so chances are she's not in this area.
So do we want to stop
but let's,
at this
let's
point?
Just take a look.
Double check.
So you've got your three brood frames in the middle, right? That's your brood nest.
That's a lot of
now you're going to have a lot of brood. There is pollen on it.
So one of the things you could do is look down the face of the cone. The queen stands out a little taller.
We're going to open the brood nest with another
typically find her. I don't see any more
cone. Now it looks like we need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
I'm assuming that
two more highly colored
cones. This is new.
Right.
Let's take this frame out.
We don't no, because we have eggs in there.
So it must not have been a built out one.
So as soon as they realize they're queenless, which will happen in a couple hours.
We'll recap all this.
They're already started.
They're going to pick certain larvae.
And that's what they're storing for the winter.
They're going to say you're going to be a queen. They'll make.
Yeah, or they're using it for food.
No, so what they do is they build the cell just in case they need it. They only lay in it when they're either going
this
to swarm
one's
or they want to
oh, get out. This one's just all soft.
And then sometimes they
okay.
turn down.
That's relatively, how can you tell the age of comb?
The darkness.
Okay.
Make their own queen.
And the difference between capped brood and capped honey, the color?
Brown and white.
Brown and white.
Go ahead and slide these in. We'll put these things back.
Now, do we want to put a couple honey supers in here while we're at it?
Yeah. Let's
put these back in.
So why don't we, Bob? How do you want to sit? Do you have any empties? You want to put empties in this, right?
Yes. So what I did is I brought some with foundation and some without, so we can alternate them. What I want to do is see which one they dry faster, foundation or foundationless. So how many empties?
So spread these
two
out. I got 7 frames, so I need 3.
I'll put this and one is the foundation.
Okay. I'm going to put that one in the middle. Put that one on the outside.
Are you using this for a drone?
No, this is a starter strip. They'll hang full foundation off of that, or full...
That's good enough.
Yeah,
perfect.
I was going to say.
So,
take a look at
another
one
go ahead and put it in.
They'll do what they want to
okay,
do.
Okay, just a little right. piece of wood there.
I want to put this in the middle. And what we want to do with this is we want to put it between 2 good frames, right?
This is the crappy frame.
So let's put it, how's the other side of that one? Try
empty frames already.
I just used
between
is that good face?
Looks pretty nice, yeah.
What I do?
Yes, I think I did this.
I just put that in that way. Instead of, that's your, you can.
Let's put that one in.
I find you don't need it.
Is that side
wax
better?
Health.
Turn
it
around
hurt,
for me.
Sure.
I like that little edge. Oh, that's what I didn't do.
Okay, and then let's put the good face against
the...
Watch. If you have bees on the edge, you just take it and lower it like this, and they'll feel that pressure and they'll move out of the way, and then you can set it down and they're gone. Okay?
I slide mine.
You could slide them too.
I start on a corner.
Just a little.
I'll just slide it and push them out.
So now we're going to lift this next one
and
over
put
to
it down
back.
Here. Yeah.
Somebody grab that.
You
want to
smoke that?
That's another thing. You guys, need to watch the smoker in this weather. If it tips over or something like that, you can have a small fire. So you got to watch that smoker and take care of it.
Smoke right in the entrance, David.
Everything just the
you're really even looking at us, huh?
No, I gotta look at it. fly in.
Really go for it. Okay.
Smoke them. Look. Okay. They're either going to come up or they're going to come off. Okay, go get the first one. Now, if you smoke them like that, that's where the queen is going to go south, right? She's going to do what she's going to do.
She's going to go down below.
Are they really drunk? You can see how tight these are. No, that's why I'm not a particular fan anymore of 10 frames.
Put a square on there.
I have 9 more. It's
beautiful. Is it true that the queens cannot stay?
Queens can stay.
They can stay.
They
multiple
can stay.
Times.
Yes.
Oh.
Will they sting you? Boy, they are not happy.
They don't like to sting. Yeah, they sting each other.
Here.
Hey, you want to try this?
Just got it, though. I'm going to put in the hanger now.
Yep.
I got to get one of these hangers. We're looking, probably going to find a queen in the center here.
Most likely. Go ahead and try the next one. If you want, I'll grab it.
Queen is bigger than a drone?
She's longer she's and she's long. Got shorter wings.
Yeah.
She's not fat like a drone.
Oh, almost dropped it. Don't see it, right? Feels really heavy. So yeah, I'm guessing. I didn't even look at it actually. I was looking for her. Okay.
We're kind of playing it by ear right now.
See,
depending on what we have, what we can do. Now, we just took a lot of it to make that one.
Right here, I'm going to let you use that.
All
you have to do is break it and then pull it. Make sure when you grab it, you have a firm grip and come straight up with it. You feel how funny it feels to once you get it out, like what you typically want to do with your other hand is put it on the bottom somewhere and use it like this.
See anything over there, David?
She may not be marked. They may have replaced her, so you have to look. Yeah, you may have to look.
So that's not her, then?
No.
That's a big drone.
She'll be long and slender.
Yep.
Ah, that's lots of honey. I don't think I like this thing.
Oop, I'm blowing. Look, see?
Sparks.
And blowing embers, which is bad. That's why you typically want to test it. So if you want to get the thing not to burn so much, if you put it on its side, it tends not to burn through the fuels part.
I pack mine real tight.
All right, so you got brood on here.
Got one more frame to look at. So.
Well, I guess we should be looking at the bottom.
I've been peeking at the bottom to see if I see her anywhere.
That. Another one then?
Yep. You go get the next one.
For us.
We're finished for
I will always have a guitar
and wire lamps.
Okay.
Some people are good at it.
They're
there's medicinal.
Seal her for a couple of days.
For two.
Look at how the other bees, all the bees are just orient toward her. Queen, when you're in a hive like this, she's moving.
Is that her right there?
Right there, yeah.
Watch her. She's the one that
found her.
Got her. All right. We're going to put her in the noose.
That was pretty good, dude.
Yes.
She's coming down here.
Wait, before you put her away, hold on.
I want to get a picture of her.
This, if I'm doing this, I'm not doing the nuke. I'm going to...
All right, where is she? She's right
there.
Here.
So, yeah, they superseded her.
Yep.
Because she was marked last year.
Did they throw her out or what? I mean...
Don't know.
Or she split.
Either that or they raised a new one and she killed the old one.
Can you turn it this way so it's in
I
the
can.
Sun? There you go. So she's right here.
That frame
yep.
is nicely packed.
There she is.
So you're transferring a nice little load there.
Yep. So let's make a nice nuke here with the queen in it. So what do we want?
Okay,
we
go
want
ahead.
We queen, we want some brood, and we want some pollen, and we want some honey. So can we find it? Well, should we wait till the other one to get a pollen cell out of there?
So now I'm mixed
I'll
up.
I'll just lock them up.
Yeah, we'll explain.
I thought we were doing here what we
yep.
Just to understand what the nukes are, sometimes I put three frames and then two frames.
Do we want a frame of honey?
So no.
I'll put four frames.
This we want to leave this hive intact too. So we need to make sure that there's eggs or young larvae in here.
So we may have to pull one of those back.
We may. So somebody look in here, or we could maybe take one out of here, Kevin.
Yep. Okay.
Well, we're going to expand that, by the way.
The reason I'm using a nuke is we're trying to split into really as many as four if we can. Two into four, that's a lot. So
this is all open.
Have enough to do.
Not got any eggs in it?
Looks like this is eggs.
This,
this looks like larva over here.
A lot of
brood
on this side.
I mean, you can do it.
So this is good to keep in here because there's brood, right?
Yep. So you could put it back in.
You know, slap a couple frames in and get them started. Not too long. I would say about a week, in my opinion, and then right away I go to a D.
You know, or you
just
can
to
put
get
a,
them
you
stabilized.
Put a second box on the top. I have extra
this
boxes.
This is great.
You could put a little nuke, a second super on the little nuke box, and you can build on
and
three or
brood,
four.
Right? Not a lot of brood, but there's brood and cat
yeah,
honey.
Yeah, they're pretty cool.
And
they're
I can see.
I do see
you make a nice
some
garden hive.
You see any larvae in there?
Like that? Them out there?
It looks like the stuff right here
yeah,
is
there's
larva,
a, there's
right?
a handful.
That's older larva. It's not yeah. the little babies.
What do you got on the other side?
Larva, capped pollen.
You do have larva, right?
Yep.
What do you got over here? Is there any eggs? Yep, come on in.
Yes, there are some teeny little eggs. So in the corner is eggs, and then the big white ones is larva, and the brown stuff is pollen.
Do you want to do your...
There's arguments for everything. So some people feel they want to use them. Some people want to use the regular bees. Something that I haven't seen in a long time. You see those
check the last one just for.
There? Those are called shallots.
Think about how many frames of brood were in this box. The thing
yes.
is completely loaded with bees, and there was brood in the top and the bottom all the way through.
You got honey on this side.
All kinds of pollen. In this one.
What they're doing is they're letting the the hive raise their own.
The pollen is the
what I do
is the orangey looking
the stuff that's halfway out.
Not the liquid shiny.
And
right?
this is
that's
capped honey.
Yep.
Right?
Yep.
If they raise their own queen to supersede the old one. There's going to be a very small amount of time where they're
people that
both in there at the same time.
Yeah,
correct?
It's not actually uncommon for two queens to be in a hive sometimes.
These are going to now supersede.
Could have
right?
been in there
talking
still.
16
yes.
You want to look at those, Kevin? And then
all right, so how do we want to do that?
What I want to make sure there's eggs and young larvae on it, and then I'm going to show you something that...
I think we'd be better with that other one we put in.
All right, so... Okay, so maybe take a frame out of there and put it in.
Take that egg...
Oh, the one out of here?
The one that we put in the other box over here.
Okay.
That's clearly, it's in this one right here, Bob.
I know.
So come on over here. We're going to show you a technique. You guys rearrange a box since we put a bit together.
Three.
So it's got to be one of the middle ones. So what we're going after here is we're looking for the frame that had pattern, larvae, and it graduated all the way down to the eggs, right, that we saw, one of the first ones that we pulled out. And what Bob's going to do is, if you think about the way they raise a queen, what have we seen? All the queen cells are pointing down, right? And so what we want to do here, or what we're going to do is, we're going to create a down shelf for the queen.
Okay, there's eggs here.
To do the eggs. So watch what Bob's going to do. He's going to notch this frame. This is the mel.
Can somebody hold this for me, please?
So what he's going to do is create the vertical shelf for the bees. It's hard, old comb, right? But he's going to notch it there. Now what you're going to have is the top of the cell is going to create a vertical surface now for them to work from. Okay?
And that's where they're going to super.
And they're going to actually build the wax from the egg down, build that peanut shaped cell in that notch.
Right there, where I crushed the comb in?
Right here?
Yep. Uh-huh. So I basically took the bottom wall off so that they can build the queen cell down, because the queen cells hang down like a peanut. Uh-huh. So this encourages them to do it there.
We took their queen away and they'll raise a new one.
Shall we put an empty frame in here? You got it? You got a any
one with honey?
Drawn?
One of the drawn combs?
These all. That
yeah,
one?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, you got those. Okay. All right, let's button this hive back up, David, and
what do we need? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. We need two more.
You got two on the outside. All right, so if the queen
here's
something
thing that I like to do.
Okay.
Push your frames together, right? Instead of moving one at a time and risks crushing them all, now we're going to move three at a time, right? So that way you're only risking these bees over here instead of in between every frame. Okay?
So we took the queen out of this hive. It's queenless. What would the bees do if they had a queenless hive? They would try to promote an egg that's 1 or 2 days old to a queen. We notched that area right at the eggs to promote them to do that. So hopefully they'll build a frame or build a queen cell.
All right, I'm going to dump these in too. I'm going to shake them in, right?
Yep.
All right.
So incidentally, the springtime right now, while they've got a nectar flow, yep, you could actually just take the whole box and put it right in. This is the best time to get rid of your old comb. Put in fresh foundation, rotate out your comb in case it has pesticides and stuff in it.
I see the sliding technology.
But what else do we want to do on that hive? What do we want this hive to be doing now while it's raising a queen?
Feed it.
No?
No.
All these bees, they have no brood to raise. What are they going to do? They're going to forage. They're going to be bringing in nectar, right? So what do we need on this one?
Honey supers.
We need a super.
Watch your fingers there, Dave.
This is a little different than what most people do. So, I use foundationless frames. So what I do is I take the popsicle stick and instead of putting it in flat, I put it in so it makes a little ridge. You see that little ridge? So the bees can build down on it. So what happens is when they build all this and fill it up with honey, I can make cut comb out of it just by cutting it out, or I can just cut it out and do crush and strain, which is what I do because I don't have an extractor. Okay?
Do you use an excluder when you do this?
No.
No? Do you just mix, I mean, when you harvest your honey, if there's larvae in there, that just gets strained out.
Or
also,
you can
right?
put the excluder in beforehand, you know, a week before you're going to do the honey and let all the brood hatch out.
Yeah.
I find that if this box has a lot of honey in it, the queen won't come up and lay in the honey super. Okay. Most of the time. Anyway, if you're going to do this, what you need to do is you need to give them a guide Otherwise, most of the time they will cross comb. And by cross combing, I mean they'll connect comb from this frame to this frame. And it makes a mess, because when you go like this and you break it, now you've got honey all over the place and bees all over the place. So you need to give them a guide, either a drawn frame that has already been drawn out, or in this case, and put it right in the middle, so that they can start on that one, and then they'll draw the rest of them nice and straight. We'll take that inner cover off.
Yeah, we need to seal them up here for a little bit. They're all pretty aggravated.
Yep.
So you run, you're running 10 in there, is that because of that?
Right.
Yep.
Yeah, nothing there either.
You got a drone on the bottom.
Oh, it's a queen cell. Right here. And it's capped.
Yep.
So we got a queen cell, so they don't have a queen right now, but there's your queen right there. So yep. You see that? It's capped. You see that? Hold it up so you can see it's capped. So within a week, that thing is going to hatch. So there's your queen. That's why there's no brood in this box. They've already swarmed, obviously, right? Either that or the queen. What happens before they swarm, the queen slows down or stops laying, okay? Because she's got to slim down and get ready to fly. So she's either in there and she's slimmed down and they're ready to go. Usually, though, if you see one swarm cell, there's more. So we got to look. There's probably more in there. And that's good because we can use that to make a few more hives. I hope there's more. This would be perfect, wouldn't it?
Yeah. We wouldn't be able to do the one method, but we could do the other.
Yeah.
Right?
Yep. That's why you gotta play the cards that you're dealt. Now it's drone on the bottom.
So now you could probably just pop them out and then slide them back in. You know, pick it up and put it back in and slide it back towards you. Yep.
Okay,
just what you just told
them. That's the only queen cell we have in there.
It's pretty
risky, right?
Yeah.
Because if she hatches and she goes out to mate and she gets eaten by a bird, you're queenless, right? So we usually like to have a couple of queen cells in there just in case. Yeah, in the old box.
Don't they usually put them right next to each other, like made on shelf, so that they'll probably do three or four right there?
Usually they put a couple of them together.
See any on the bottom?
I do not see any on the bottom.
No, that's just a queen cup there on the corner, right?
There's a queen cup.
Yeah,
you have to tilt it up so we can look in the bottom of it. You see anything in there? I do not. It is empty. Okay. So this is that thing in the front, and I said you got to put this end in first.
Oh, I see. Yep.
Yeah.
The guard.
So it gets past the guard.
I don't see more queen cells. Or a queen.
You know, it's funny. As soon as you open this hive, you could hear the sound. It was different to me. Just like last time I was here.
It was a roar the last
time. They were really not happy last time we were here when we opened this hive. But it just had a different sound, a different tone to it. See anything on the bottom there?
Yeah, there's one.
Yep.
Yep.
And it's capped, right?
Yes, it is. Here, it's a big one. Turn it. Can you turn it around? We'll get a picture of it. Brush the bees off of it.
Go ahead and shake it in the box.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Shake it down. You okay with that? You know, he can flick them off if you want. Okay, yeah. Now we could show it. Yep. So right here. That's some ugly comb on the bottom there.
It sure is.
So you want to hand it around, you can now. Hand that frame.
Handle this frame?
Find some more, so we can at least leave two in this box. Right?
I see a supersedure cell on the face there. See it? So we have to look at that one too.
Just going back in, or are you going to
yeah,
use this
put it, cell? Put it back in.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, we should be able to get six out of this then, I think.
Well, you only found two, right, so far? So we don't want to take them. Yeah.
I'm confident. I'm sorry.
He's all excited.
Matter of fact, if we don't, I'll go home and get some queen cells out of mine.
And bring them in here.
Bring them in and just drop them in.
Here's a plastic frame. So this one we saw has a supersedure on the face, not on the bottom. You'll see.
This one on this side, it's not capped either.
This one's capped.
So the one that's not capped probably hatched.
So you got, was this one capped?
Well, there's, look at, there's three of them on
this
side.
There's one here.
One here.
There's one here, one here, one here, one there. There's none along the bottom.
So we can put that one frame into a box by itself.
And then there's one over here, too.
That one's capped.
And it's capped. So if you've ever seen the Fat Bee Man on YouTube, he just goes in with a knife and he cuts each one of these out and he puts them in. Don Kirshner.
So what you would do is you just cut, make sure you got way up here, got the comb, and just take this peanut out. I did it last week, and then just put it in between two frames, drop it right in here, and then the queen will hatch out. She's due in about a week. So what do you want to do with this one? This is a hive maker right here.
That's a hive maker.
You want to put it in here?
I would take that frame with the eggs and put it back in here or somewhere else, and that one can be this. Because there's brood in there, there's bees in there. Well, let's just set it on the hanger for now, Bob. We could, you want to look for more?
Yeah, because then we can decide what we're going to do.
All right.
But that's right there, that one is.
Yeah. So it's plastic frame with the white on the outside. This one ain't even built out yet, so I don't know what you got in there.
So I get excited when I see queens.
It's a serendipity.
Those are free queens, right?
Yeah.
I want to make six hives today. I want to end up with six hives.
There was a,
that helps me a lot.
There was $120 on that frame.
Yeah.
If you think about it, that's $120 worth of bees, right?
There's a queen cell, right?
There's a cell.
It's
it looks uncapped. So that's the other thing is she may be out.
Okay.
You'll see. So how do you know if it's if it's a newly hatched queen? That one looks newly hatched, and I'm going to show you why. You want to hold my camera? Let me show you this.
So we may have a virgin queen in here.
We may have a virgin queen. Now look at the bottom of that frame. Look at the bottom of that.
Yeah. Okay.
See how it's chewed?
Yeah. Okay.
So what they do is they chew around the edge to loosen it, and then the queen can pop it right off. So if you see that it's chewed on the bottom, that means somebody just came out of there.
We should look. Essentially full
I
size
bet she's in here somewhere.
Or... Yeah, she's full size.
She's full size. Okay.
She'll come out and she'll mature for a day or two and harden up and do whatever, but...
We'll show that again, Kevin.
That so could that could very well be a newly emerged queen, one of the first ones out. Now, it's hard to tell whether it's new or old, but usually when you see the frayed, you could see it's frayed, right, when you're looking at it. So that's how you know she's newly emerged. That they just recently got her out of there. So, could you find any more bees in this box?
Here, Kevin.
Thanks.
That's why it swarmed, right?
It's just incredible.
Right? Exactly what happened. It swarmed because the bottom box was full of bees, the top box was bound with honey. There was nowhere for the queen to lay, right? And she said, time to go.
So the swarm is not necessarily a bad thing, it's just the way that they keep healthy by not being too
overpopulated. It's a bad thing in that you lose half of your bees.
But if you still have a full hive of bees, who cares?
Well,
you don't have a queen.
If you would have two hives full of bees to make honey if they didn't swarm.
Okay.
Yeah, so here in the middle of the field, it's not a bad thing because they could become feral bees and do whatever they're going to do. When you're at home and you're next to your neighbors and the swarm is hanging off their gutter, it's not a good thing,
okay,
right? So you have to have perspective about where that swarm is going to take off to. As a general rule for beekeepers, we want to try and not have swarms. People get very excited when they see thousands of bees. That one looks just like
there's nothing there. So what are we going to do now, Kevin? Tell us what we're going to do now that we've got. So what do we have? Let's recap. We've got one frame that's got a bunch of queen cells on it, right?
Yep.
We have two other frames that have at least one queen cell on it, and that's it, right? So we have three frames with queen cells on it.
And one queen cell in here that
has already
hatched.
Right. So we've got the potential to make three more hives, which is one. We only really, two, three, right? We need three,
right.
So that's perfect.
Yep.
We'll be able to end up with six. So what Kevin was suggesting is that we take the frame, just like there's so many bees in here, and nurse bees it looks like, that we take the frame with eggs and young larvae and put it in here, take the one with the queen cells and put one in here,
yep.
One in there,
yep.
And one in here.
And one in this one.
All right.
Now they don't have queen cells or nurse bees in here because there's no brood.
Oh, that's right.
Right. But if we transfer the frame that we took over here with the nurse bees on it, they'll have nurse bees to it.
Okay.
So I think you'd be okay with it.
So we need to open up the brood nest because we want to put it in the center. And I'll go in and find this one.
So there's actually another frame of brood in here too.
I think there is.
So we could probably take two of those in
and put the queen cells in.
And
here.
We should take some of these frames out of here so it's not totally loaded.
Yeah.
And put them in the other hives and stock them with bees.
Yes.
Right? Perfect.
Yep.
All right, so in this for the video, in this one we took some frames out of another hive earlier and put them in here for storage. And we have frames of honey and we have frames of brood. And since we now have more equity in bees, we're going to change our strategy for this box. That looks like the frame that had all the pollen and nectar in it. That next one is clearly the brood frame. All right.
Oh yeah, look at that.
So that's a solid brood frame and those are nurse bees on it. Oops, my camera.
Okay, I don't see any. There's a couple of small larvae here, but probably no eggs. So we'll put this one in.
This is going back in here?
Yeah.
Well, we want to look, see, I want to see if there's another frame like this.
You could put that one in for now, though.
So those are identified as nurse bees because they're over the brood?
They're over the brood.
Different.
Right. If they're on the brood frame, chances are they're nurse bees.
Okay, because the foragers are out foraging.
Foragers are out foraging.
This is pollen.
That one's a pollen and
so what
nectar.
What happened to the other one with the?
It might be here.
Yeah, eggs on it.
There's definitely one in there. I'm betting it's this one. Is that it?
Nope.
No.
Nope.
Did we move that one here to the nuke?
I don't think we put it in the nuke.
No, we put the queen in the nuke.
The next one has some brood on it. I see. The next one over.
Oh yeah, that's it.
Isn't that the one you just pulled out though?
I thought so.
This makes for good television.
This has pollen and drone brood. Shall we put this one in there?
Let's see what the other side looks like, no?
More pollen.
And yeah.
Some capped brood. There's some uncapped brood, but it's pretty,
that's honey.
Pretty large.
Yeah, I don't know what happened to that frame. Unless that was it that you had. I would put that one in, Bob.
I see some small larvae there. I think we saw the eggs up there. Can you see eggs? Up in the top, up here in this corner.
You gotta tilt it down a little more for me. I do see, let me not get in the shade. Yeah.
There's
yep,
eggs,
right through here there's some.
All right, so we're gonna put that in here.
Yep. So when you see Randy Oliver, if you come into the thing, he'll talk to you about how do you know your bees are healthy? If those eggs are in a pool of jelly, the hive is doing good, right? If the bottom of the cell is dry, then you have the potential for problems.
Empties in here or no?
I would.
So, somebody give me. I'll take one foundation. Listen, one foundation.
So what do we have in here? We have nothing, right? So we want to put. Do we want to put that queen?
I want to put that frame that's got the four.
That's this one.
Cells on it in there.
Okay.
And that's good there.
Yep, you could put it right in the middle there. So there goes the money frame.
Bees and all, right? Is that the one with there with all the mini?
That's the one with all the stuff on it.
One, two, three.
Right.
And it's quite a nice one.
Yeah.
I even like
it. Recognize that.
Yeah.
Some of those on the bottom, I never quite sure if they are.
I would squeeze all of those. These two have honey on them, right? Yep. They put honey on the outside. Let's move that this way. We want the brood to be in the middle on the bottom when they go. So that's good. And then if you have an empty frame, it would be good to put alongside that one. So we could take one of these empties over here.
And we're gonna put this back on top of here, right, Kevin, with the honey in it? Split that one up.
I would take some of that honey and put it in a box on top of this, no?
Yeah.
You got another box?
Take off the hanger, right?
Yeah, you
got. So the ones that are on the hanger have the other, so we want to put them in that box. Let's take the three that are on the hanger.
Yep.
and put them in that far box. No, Bob?
What do we have in here? Oh, we have the eggs.
Yeah.
And we have queen cells. And yeah, so we want to put the rest of the queen cells in there, right?
So yes, and they're on that. Cells. They're on those.
Yeah. So put them right in the center.
So put those right in the center of the other box.
What we'll have to do is take, there's more honey here. We'll take one of these boxes and put it on top of each of those.
Yep.
Right? Okay, so we're going to take these three that have queen cells on them. We want to look at them again, see what we've got.
Yeah, they have capped, both those two should have capped cells on them. There's one right here.
Is it on the bottom here?
There it is. Okay, so there's that one.
I don't see that one. I know that one definitely has one. I thought there was one on the bottom of that.
I thought there was two. Unless we put, hope we didn't put it in the.
I would put it over there.
And this one as well?
Yep.
In the new box.
No, did you find a queen cell on there?
No.
Is it still in that box? So. Must have put it back in, right? Because we had two of them. And the other queen cell looked nicer than that cruddy old brown one we had. We can put that in anyway because we could use the bees in this box right there. So we're going to go look in here for it again.
If it's in here, it's this one, or that one.
Okay.
Right? So yeah. We could pull those. So I'm out of film here, but what we're basically doing is we're just going to button all these things up. And that one, remind me what we did in the nuke, Bob.
The queen is there. She needs four more frames. She's only got one frame in there.
So we put the queen in here.
So we need pollen and some brood in here.
Or this one has the money frame.
Yeah, we didn't have any brood in here.
This one we just put eggs and larvae fresh in. And that one over there, we're trying to find some queen cells, which we will put in. And then we'll put everybody back together. And what did we do with this one? The original one.
This one is queenless. She's got eggs.
She's got eggs.
And lots of bees and honey in this box.
Yep.
So this is our honey maker, really. We're hoping this one will make a ton.
And that's the one we notched, right?
Right.
So that's what we got going on. All right.
What we have to do is we need to get at least a frame of pollen and honey. And then I can put a couple empties in that one with the queen, right? So we need a pollen frame from here.
We're still trying to find the queen. Okay.